The body's first defenses against infections are physical, chemical, and enzymatic barriers, which prevent organisms from colonising tissues. If these barriers are insufficient or breached, then the innate immune system kicks in. In this experiment, we'll examine the activity of the antibacterial enzyme, Lysozyme. Lysozyme degrades peptidoglycan in bacterial cell walls and can be found in a variety of human body fluids, such as saliva and tears. Peptidoglycan is a polymer of sugar residues, which provides structural rigidity to bacterial cell walls. Lysozyme breaks the glycosidic bond connecting the sugar residues within peptidoglycan, and the loss of a rigid cell wall leaves the bacterium vulnerable to osmotic swelling and lysis. Lytic activity will be detected by the digestion and clearance of bacterial cell walls using heat-killed bacteria incorporated into an agar plate. Test solutions are placed in wells in the agar and give a zone of clearance of the opaque bacterial suspension if Lysozyme activity is present. We will test Lysozyme activity against two bacteria, Staphylococcus and Micrococcus. Label two agar deeps and two agar plates with the organisms' names, and 1 milliliter of each bacterial culture into the agar deep. And immerse them in a 60 degrees Celsius water bath for 5 minutes to kill the bacteria. Remove the agar deeps from the water bath and pour the liquid agar evenly out onto empty plates. Cover the plates, which will solidify at room temperature within 20 minutes. What we have created is a matrix of bacterial cell walls embedded into the agar for both Staphylococcus and Micrococcus. We are only interested in the Lysozyme's specific ability in destroying the cell wall, and by killing the bacteria in this fashion, the cell wall structure is preserved throughout the agar. When we punch holes in the agar and add different compounds into the resulting wells, zones of clearing should appear when the cell wall components are degraded. This gives us an indirect way of measuring Lysozyme activity in different substances. We'll be testing four solutions: purified hen egg Lysozyme, phosphate buffer, penicillin, and egg white. With a 200 microliter pipette, add 25 microliters of test solutions to the wells. Egg white is considerably more viscous, so use a pus pipette instead to transfer it into the well. The plates are incubated at room temperature for 24 hours and flooded with 1 molar sodium hydroxide to inactivate enzymatic activity and fix the zones of clearance. Let's look at the results for Micrococcus first. We see zones of clearance for purified hen egg Lysozyme, as well as egg white, which is enriched in Lysozyme. This makes sense, as the Lysozyme present in these solutions can break down the peptidoglycan found in the cell wall components embedded throughout the agar. We do not see zones of clearance for phosphate buffer, which does not contain Lysozyme, or penicillin. Lysozyme and penicillin both act on peptidoglycan and both result in a weakened cell wall, leading to osmotic lysis. However, penicillin is an inhibitor of an enzyme involved in peptidoglycan synthesis, not the structural component of the cell wall itself. It only acts on growing cells and will have no activity on the existing cell walls from dead bacterial cells in our assay. Lysozyme is an enzyme which degrades peptidoglycan and can attack growing or non-growing cells. Hopefully that makes sense, but what about Staphylococcus? No zones of clearance are observed in any of the wells. This is due to the fact that Staph aureus is resistant to Lysozyme due to a modification of its peptidoglycan structure. Specifically, Staph aureus is resistant to Lysozyme due to the OAT-A gene encoding an enzyme which alters the Lysozyme binding site in its version of peptidoglycan. And this is evidence of Staph aureus's changing defense mechanisms against our own innate immune defense. This experiment has demonstrated key principles relating to innate immunity and showcases the never-ending evolutionary arms race between pathogens and our immune response.